K-Tel Music presents the greatest singers of all time collection, starring Bing Crosby, Frank Sinatra, Nat King Cole, Dean Martin, Michael Bublé, and Mr.Shay.
The falling leaves pass by my window.
Autumn leaves.
Whoa.
Take two.
Okay. The falling leaves, they pass by my window. Oh.
Autumn leaves. Take three.
Falling leaves, they pass by my window. Okay, well, that's enough of that. Well, hello there. Welcome back to the art room. I'm really glad you could make it today. In case you haven't guessed, today's project is all about leaves. We're going to be using some autumn leaves to make some wonderful paintings and some rubbings on black paper, so join us in the art room. This is going to be a great fall episode. Okay, for our project today, we're going to need some black construction paper, 9x12, that's what I'm using, some leaves, tempera paint or acrylic paints, white crayon or a colored pencil, some paper towels, a paintbrush, something to squirt paint on, like a paper plate or a regular plate, and we are good to go. First, we'll talk about your leaves. This time of year, you shouldn't have any trouble finding leaves. As I said, it's October here in Ohio, where I am. But if you're doing this at a different part of the year, there are always leaves lying around. It seems like you just can't get rid of them. So get out in your yard, get some leaves. I will say this about your leaves, though. Now, here's some leaves. You can hear how crunchy that one is. These are the leaves that were kind of up against the fence in my backyard, and they're very, very crunchy. It might give you a hard time printing with leaves like that. So what I normally do is I just get like a little container, and I soak the leaves for about an hour, and when they absorb a lot of water, they're real nice and kind of rubbery and easy to work with. So I'm going to pick out a couple of different leaves, maybe different leaf styles here. See what we've got in the old box here. Okay, there's an oak leaf. That might be kind of pretty. I'm going to get that. And I'm going to get a maple leaf. Isn't that beautiful? Wow. And maybe one more here. Come on. That little guy there. He's kind of pretty too. So I've got my leaves that I'm going to be using. So, paper towel then. If your leaves are wet, dry them down a bit. You don't have to be totally dried off, but we don't want them to be soaking wet either. We want them to be kind of receptive to putting some paint on them. Okay, so I've got some leaves here. Good variety of leaves. Okay, so let's set those aside for a moment. I'm going to grab my black construction paper. It really wouldn't have to be black. It could have been any color you want. Here's a black piece of construction paper. And like I did with this one, I'm going to kind of set the stage and kind of do like a little inset border here with either a white crayon or a white colored pencil, just to kind of set the stage and kind of add a little drama and maybe kind of a finished quality. So you can use a ruler if you want to for this part. I'm not going to, but if you want to, go ahead. I'm just going to create a little inside border here across my paper, like that. And it might even be better if it has like a little, you know, a little wobble here and there. I kind of like that artistic wobble going on there. Okay. So that's going to be my border. I'm going to write autumn leaves down here. Those autumn leaves. right there. And then I'm going to date it. Some point in time, you might get this back out again and go, wow, I remember doing that picture in 2022 with Mr. Shay in the art room. We're ready then. So I'm going to grab a paper towel, and this is going to be, I'm going to use paper towels for quite a few things in this, but I'm going to set my leaves down onto my paper towel. Okay, now I'm going to set them with the veiny side up. The veiny side, there's a veiny side, and then there's a kind of a smoother side, usually the side that has all the pretty colors. We need the side that's got the bumpy veins on it, so I'm going to lay those down. Let's see, what else have I got over here? I have a couple other ones. Gotta use that oak leaf. Okay, so I'm going to get my plate, and let's draw back here just a bit. All right, and I'm going to put some pretty colors on my plate. Now, nobody said you have to use fall colors. I did on mine. I did use fall colors, but that's just my preference. But I do have a little bit of green in there because some of these leaves kind of exhibit a little bit of green left in them, you know, kind of like my oak leaf here with a little bit of green. So I'm going to squirt some tempera paint down. Isn't that pretty? There's just something about when you pour paint. Gives me goosebumps every time. And put that down. And I think I'll put a little orange down. Yeah. And okay. A little orange. And then a little green. And green will make some nice kind of highlights there around our other colors. And you know, if I want to, I can even put blue or purple down. Let's try a little blue. Let's get dangerous here, huh? Why not? Let's get a little dangerous. A little blue on there. Okay. Before I lay my leaves down, though, I'd like to create a little bit of an idea of some branches. So back to my white crayon, and the secret of good branches is to be random. You know, did you ever get nervous? You ever have a nervous hand where you just can't control your hand? If you're nervous today, you're in the right place. Because just kind of let it wiggle around like this and really do kind of a neat stem branch, and I'm just kind of wiggling it around like that. And almost looks like lightning at this point. And just trying to create some interesting branches that are growing off of one another. Use your imagination. And some tiny, teeny ones. And there's one that kind of goes off that way. All right, I like my branches. That's good. Pardon me. Then let's get our leaf, and I think I'll start with the big guy first here. I'm going to put him right there, and time for my paintbrush then. Really doesn't matter what kind of a paintbrush you've got. I'm going to go with this kind of a red sable brush that I've got here, and let's load up our leaf, and remember, we're working on the side with the veins, so I'm just going to be spreading a nice coating of yellow on my leaf. Boy, that's pretty. There's just something about painting. Every time we paint in the art room, I look forward to it just so much. You just don't get to paint. That's what the kids in the art room always ask me. Hey, are we painting today, Mr. Shay? Yeah, we are. Okay, so there's a good start. Now I'm going to introduce some other colors. How about some red on my brush here? And I'm going to maybe make some red tips. Paint that leaf up. Hard to paint your leaf as good as Mother Nature could, though, I'll tell you that. There are some beautiful colors out there. So, I kind of blend that in. All right, let's see what we can do then. I'm going to pick a nice spot for my leaf, and I'm going to put it face down onto my paper. Just let it sit there. I'm going to get another piece of paper towel and lay it on top of the leaf here, little chunky piece here. And I'm going to use this sort of a pounce method here. And I'm rattling everything on the art room table. Okay, but it's worth it. So I'm going to really, and if you have paint on your stem, don't forget to do the stem. Okay, pounce it down real good. Hold on tight. You don't want your leaf to be moving around too much. Okay, that's good enough. Let's peel that back and see what we did. Whoa! Oh my goodness, that's great. Oh, that's great. My leaf stuck to my paper, and that's fine. You see what we did that first time? Oh, that's so pretty. Okay, we'll go again here. I'm going to use a different leaf this time, I think. Let's see. Let's flip it over. And what am I going to get this time? I think I'm going to go with red, maybe. And we'll paint that leaf bright red. Oh, that's pretty. And I think I'll put a little bit of yellow on the tips of it this time. Don't be afraid to really load your paint up. And just for the fun of it, I think I'm going to dip into that green and go around the back part of my leaf with green there. Okay. And I've got some water here on my desk too, in case you hadn't noticed. So I'm going to take our leaf again. Let's pick another cool spot for a leaf. Like, how about down, right about down there? And back to my paper towel. I'm going to pound that down in there, or rub it. Someday in the art room, we'll talk about printing with a brayer and printer's ink. That's kind of the next logical step after you're doing this kind of printing. Okay. Oh, that's a beautiful one. I think that one's as pretty as my first one. Okay. Let's do it again. How about, let's get my brush clean here. Let's add some different colors maybe. And I think this time I'm going to get into that blue. Can autumn leaves be blue? Sure can. In art they can. That's the power of art for you. So there we go. Got some blue. I think I'm going to spend a little time getting some yellow in there. Kind of reaching that in. Don't forget to paint the stem if you want. And then some red out here on the tips maybe. Oh, that's pretty. All right, let's see how this one prints up. I think I'll face my leaf a little different direction this time. And it looks like I need another piece of paper towel here. Okay, let's set that down on top. And here we go again. I think that's my favorite one of the bunch so far. And let's try. I got a kind of a blend of green and blue and yellow going here. Paint that one. And let's see how that turns out. Okay, how about over there? Kind of trying to keep kind of a neat flow of where my leaves are going. Okay. Put that there. Let's... knocking everything loose on my art table, but hey, it's worth it. That's the price of art for you here. Okay. Okay. Let's peel that. Oh, wow. Oh, that one's nice too. Okay. Here's a little bit smaller one I found today. I'm not sure what kind of a tree that's from. Or maybe it's a plant leaf. I'm not quite sure. Maybe somebody out there does. But I think this time I'm going to introduce a little bit of white to the mix. Whoops, put a little white on there. Okay, let's see how the white one turns out. And don't forget to get the vein side of your leaf there. I love to paint. Oh gosh, that's great. Isn't it fun being an artist? It is. So I'm gonna paint my little leaf here. Paint that one white. Don't forget the stem. Let's see, can I put a little, why not put a little pink in it maybe? A little red rather. Yeah, let's see how that one turns out. Okay, see what I've got? Where's a good spot? Up here, maybe. Up here. Stick that one right there. And where's my paper towel? There it is. Okay. Let's rub that one down real good. And see what happened there. Oh, that one's neat. That's got a good character about it, too. In fact, I think I like that little one so well, I'm going to give him a repeat performance here. Put a little yellow in him there. And how about a little touch of blue, too? Right there. Might be good. All right. Never know how these are going to work out. Let's put that one down there. Okay, back to my paper towel again. Okay. Oh, very cool. That's a nice one, too. Okay. Hey, well, that, I think, is where we're going to end things. I could keep going and going and going, of course, but I've got a really kind of a nice little composition going, so I think I'm just going to leave it there. Okay, I hope you had as much fun doing that as I did. I certainly did. I love to paint. So remember, no matter where you go, no matter what you do, you've got something to be proud of. You're an artist. Well, stick with it, and we'll see you right back here next time in Mr. Shay's Art Room.